going to be working on a 2009 Toyota Corolla 1.8 liter automatic. I'm going to show you how to service the transmission. These are the tools I'm going to be using today to do this job. A 3/8 impact, 3/8 extension, 10 millimeter socket, 1/4 inch ratchet, 1/4 inch extension, 10 millimeter socket, long nose plier, flat tip screwdriver, parts washer brush, brake clean, and my fluid exchanger. These are the parts I'm going to be using today to do this job. A full synthetic automatic transmission fluid and a trans filter kit. So I'm going to be removing this pan. It's located on the driver's side. So these last two bolts, don't remove it, just loosen it up. And we're gonna be prying out the pan. So I'm going to be removing the filter. There's three bolts, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, so your new filter, there's an O-ring that comes with the filter. You got to make sure you put the O-ring on. Before you put it up, make sure there's no O-ring in here. If there is, remove it. So that guy looks good. So we're gonna be putting on the new filter. So just snap it in. Tightening it up. So I'm going to be cleaning up the transmission pan, removing the old gasket. Cleaning it with some brake clean. Cleaning all my magnets. So I'm going to be scraping some of this cork gasket off. Just use like a chisel, any kind of scraper. Okay, so I'm going to be hammering these holes slightly below the pan. Okay, so I'm gonna be putting my gasket on. This is a felt type of a gasket. Don't put any sealant on it because when the transmission fluid touches the gasket, it's gonna swell up a little. If you put any kind of sealant, it cannot swell up, so you defeat the purpose of this type of a gasket. So where you see these little tabs, these holes are a little bit smaller.
than the rest. So what you do is you get these bolts and just stick it through. And it's gonna be holding the gasket in place. Okay, so now we're gonna be wiping down the transmission side. So I'm gonna be wiping down the transmission side. Make sure there's no gasket stuck to the transmission. If there is, remove it. On this one, the dipstick is kind of sticking down a little. So what you can do is go to the top and pull the stick out a little so it doesn't interfere when we're putting on the pan. So I'm going to be putting on the pan. So make sure you put all the bolts on before you tighten it up. So today I'm going to be using this transmission fluid exchanger. I'm going to be putting in 4 quarts of transmission fluid just to get started. So I'm going to be putting this tube right into the transmission dipstick tube. I'm going to be pumping in 4 quarts. Okay, so now I'm gonna be connecting my machine to the transmission cooler line. I can get access to my transmission cooler lines from the top. So what I'm gonna do now is these fittings, I'm gonna be putting it in line and connecting it to my transmission flusher. Removing this clamp. Removing this hose. So I'm going to be putting on my adapters. So I connected my adapters, one side to the metal tubing and the other side to the rubber hose. So I'm gonna be flushing out this transmission with additional 9 quarts. So 9 plus 4 equals 13 quarts. So I'm gonna be putting in a total of 13 quarts and then I'm gonna have 1 quart to top off. So I'm gonna be connecting my adapters. I'm gonna turn this machine on. I'm gonna start up the engine. So now it's gonna start to flush out the transmission. It takes about maybe 10 minutes. Okay, so I'm gonna be disconnecting my machine. Okay, removing my adapters. Connecting my cooler hose. Putting on the clamp. So I'm going to be starting up the vehicle. Now we're going to be checking the transmission level. Right now it's good. But what I need to do is check this transmission while the engine is hot, like normal operating temperature. So I'm going to be driving around the vehicle a few miles, come back and then recheck the transmission fluid. So I road tested the vehicle, I checked the fluid level, I topped it off, now it's all good to go. If you have any questions, comment below, make sure you subscribe, give me a thumbs up, and I see you in the next video. Aloha.